When you see an animal that is coming a little bit distressed or something, best not to like interfere. And it's coming straight to you, just stand still and let the animal take its way. Even if an animal is coming trying to be very aggressive, you stand still, the animal will go its way.
पशुओं के प्रति संवेदनशील बनाया है। पशु कल्याण और सतत पर्यावरण के विभिन्न पहलुओं पर आप अथक रूप से काम कर रही हैं।
My name is Minnie Vasudevan. And I have been the managing trustee of Humane Animal Society right from inception in the year 2006. Humane Animal Society has been responsible for starting the animal birth control program in the city of Coimbatore. We have also been doing the rabies vaccination drives here. And most importantly, we have been doing a lot of humane education. My relationship with animals started from a very young age. Wherever I was, if there was anything I could do to help a voiceless creature like an animal, I've always done it. Because animals are sentient creatures. They are not something you can buy from a shop. It's not an inanimate object that is available for sale. So looking at an animal as a sentient creature and not exploiting commercially, it is something is fundamental to any animal welfare person, and we wanted to encourage more and more people to adopt from shelters and not go and buy from breeders. Shopping for animals is one of the biggest mistakes that anybody can do. Most of the breeders are unethical. Most of the breeders do it only for money. So we had to educate a lot of public to not to go to breeders and come and adopt. And even if they wanted, liked a purebred animal, come to a shelter and take an animal that deserves a home. In the early days when we started, it was considered as a very below status to adopt an Indian dog. What kind of breed do you have was a question everybody was asking those days, which I am proud to say today it has stopped almost. Very few people ask what breed you have. They come here because they know they get Indian dogs. And people have understood the value of Indian dogs. More than 5,000 adoptions we have done until date. The number of people that have come forward, I mean, that has been phenomenal. The support from the city in terms of the people that have come forward, not only from the city, actually from all over the world. And through social media, whenever we promote a particular incident, the kind of responses we got and the kind of, you know, reactions we got from public has been phenomenal because of the stories that we were able to show. One person on social media saw a puppy that is there, and she lives in Switzerland. And she just said, you know, I would like to adopt this dog. They paid for everything and we sent the puppy to Switzerland. It's having a time of its life. And it is just, you know, a post on social media saying we had an adoption drive. We had more than 50 adoptions and then a few dogs were left behind. And she was one of the dogs that didn't get adopted. So how the life of the animal changed because she didn't get adopted. Coimbatore Corporation was mandated to start an animal birth control center in Coimbatore. So they identified the place, which is Siranaiken Palayam. They wanted to start the ABC program. So ABC is animal birth control, and that is to control the multiplication, proliferation of street dogs, to prevent nuisance to humans and also to prevent the rabies as a disease. There wasn't enough training or exposure to the people who are running it to run it professionally. I mean, I didn't know much about veterinary science because I'm an engineer, but I've seen how it is being done. 2006 is when the organization got registered. So the whole place was offered to us to run the program on behalf of the corporation. So Blue Cross of India in Chennai is one of the oldest animal welfare organizations in the country. I visited there, I went and saw what all they are doing, what kind of trainings you have to give it to the doctors, what kind of staff you have to get, what are the basic infrastructural setup you need. Because we did not have money, resources or time. All of us are full-time working, all of us were engaged in so many things, but we had an overwhelming desire that we need to do something to help animals in the city. This last year, I was selected to receive the Nari Shakti Puraskar, which is the highest civilian honor for a woman, you know, in the country. It is never my personal dream. However, that really, you know, brought to light what this organization has achieved, which is traveled far and wide throughout the nation, and the kind of significant impact we have created. So that is the biggest ever recognition we as an organization got and it actually brings to light the tireless effort of mostly our staff and our hundreds of volunteers and our donors. The most important work of the organization happens in the shelter. See, because that is where the rescue animals come, that is where the animal birth control surgery takes place, that is where our clinic is there, that is where most of the people work here. And we have two veterinarians, veterinary assistants, we have animal caretakers, animal handlers, somebody who prepares the food. So all of that takes place in the shelter. We do an outpatient clinic only to help people to help animals. Anybody who wants to bring their pet or a community animal can bring them, get the care, take them back and revisit without bringing them here and leaving them here. More than 100 rescues are today here in the shelter. It's way more than what we can handle. So how to rehabilitate them as soon as possible is something that we have to constantly think. The shelter offers the opportunity for people to come and volunteer. So we have all of that facility here. We have overseas volunteers who travel within the city, come and say, I want to offer my services when I'm visiting the city. So it is totally free. They do it out of their heart. You don't even have to tell them what to do. They come here and they do whatever is there to be done. And the sanctuary is a place where if we cannot find a home for an animal, where would this animal go? It shouldn't live in the life all its life in the shelter, because a lot of sick animals come and go here. So we have the sanctuary. Our trustees bought the land and we given it to the trust for life. We have more than 70 animals now, including a pony and the cow. You go to the sanctuary, you feel very happy because you see an animal that is paralyzed, you know, coming to you very happily. It's showing its total happiness in seeing you. So that gives people also happiness. Sanctuary, we wanted a more educational experience for people to come and visit. Every single animal in the sanctuary, whether it is three-legged or not having an eye or lost its vision, still adoptable. Because they are living happily over there. So you show the people that it can live happily here and live happily in your home too. So one of the school correspondents who actually came to visit adopted 5 special needs dogs from our shelter and took those 5 dogs to the school because he wanted the children to see that such animals can live a full life. We also teach children how to avoid dog bites, how to behave on a street when you see a street animal. So that's very important because a lot of conflicts happen with children and dogs. Most of the time conflict arises because humans interfere with their lives. Whenever you see a female nursing or female as having puppies, is to best to avoid and, you know, go your way unless you know what you have to do or you work with animals, in which case you can give food to the mother so that the mother can take care of the puppies better. You can find homes for the puppies. You can get the mother spayed later. So many community people work on that level. Ignore street animals. Just walk as if you don't even, you know, see them. And it is animals' place too. So we have to recognize that it's not only our place. The street belongs to animals, street belongs to us. So as long as that understanding is there, we let them be, it is okay. And if a dog comes to you in a kind of dangerous way, stand still. It's difficult to practice, but we have told children to stand. We have shown examples of children. Put your hand on your shoulders, stand still. When as children you are told, it sticks to their mind. Adults, they practice it. When you see an animal that is coming a little bit distressed or something, best not to like interfere. And it's coming straight to you, just stand still and let the animal take its way. Even if an animal is coming trying to be very aggressive, you stand still, the animal will go its way. There has been a young group that has formed recently in Coimbatore called the Possum People Project. All youngsters under 30. And they have been inspired seeing the work we do, and they wanted to start a shelter. And the first thing I said was, never start a shelter. There is so much you can do outside of a shelter. And that is exactly what they're doing. They're going and they're forming groups in various communities, being more conscious and mindful of your surroundings, your environment. And these youngsters are doing exactly that. They are going into various their own localities and making a difference. And I think that has been the biggest inspiration even for us, that we have inspired them, but we have been inspired back, you know. So it is a cycle that has been, you know, completed. So the ecosystem is a very delicate balance that we all hold. And as humans, we are very responsible. So that is the message that I have to give to the youngsters, to go above and beyond the materialistic world. Think and you know, show kindness and compassion to everything around you to understand the ecosystem balance. In a conflict between a human and an animal, it's always a human that wins. Even if it's not the animal's fault, the animal doesn't win. So we have to always keep that in mind. So, yeah.